My name's Hari Ghotra. I'm a cook and a chef. I also run Hari Ghotra, which is the biggest Indian food platform across all of my channels. That includes the website, the app, which has just been launched, the YouTube channel, and of course, lots of sort of social media channels as well. Everything that I do is aimed at getting people back in the kitchen to cook. On the website, I've got something like 350 recipe videos, which include dishes from your chicken tikka masala right through to how to make a lassi. But it's all about teaching people how to use spices, how to use ingredients, and how to put an Indian meal together the way that I was taught to cook from my mum. And from some of the videos that we did, I got picked up by a restaurant called Tamarind of Mayfair, where the head chef there, Peter Joseph, was just browsing and he saw what I was doing and he contacted me and invited me to the restaurant. So I went to the restaurant and just ended up getting on with him like a house on fire. He was just an amazing guy and I ended up working with him for 2 years. And for me as a home cook, that really sort of pushed me to the next level and it just made me understand the difficulties you have in the restaurant environment, but more so in Indian food and how you take Indian food from your takeaway up to that Michelin star standard. Today I'm going to cook for you a rolled breast of lamb, which is going to be stuffed with some spicy mince. That's going to be slow cooked, so I'm just going to pan fry it first just to get a little bit of colour to it. And then I'm going to make some masala mash that is going to be nice and creamy and it's going to be bright yellow because I'm going to add a little bit of turmeric to it. So the breast of lamb is laid flat. I'm going to slash it just inside just so that the spices can penetrate into that meat a little bit. It is quite a fatty cut of meat, so you need to get into the flesh almost just so that the spices just penetrate into that meat so that you get the flavour of the spices in there. I'm then going to use some minced lamb and I'm going to add some garam masala to it. I'm going to put some cumin seeds in there, a little bit of Kashmiri chilli powder and some salt and just mix that through and then lay that on the breast and then just roll it through and then tie it up so it's really nice and compact. I'm probably gonna cut it in half so we've got two little pieces that are gonna be pan fried just to get some color to them. Color is flavor, as we say, so just a little bit of color to them. Just roll them around so they're evenly browned and then just set that to one side. So the sauce is quite a few spices. So it's got in there cloves, cardamom, cassia bark. I'm gonna put some cumin in there as well, some salt, a little bit of chili powder. But first of all, it'll be just a red onion, really roughly chopped into a pan with a little bit of oil. Just fry that off with some garlic and some ginger. The spices then go in and then I'm just gonna fill it up with some water, just essentially to make almost a stock. And some tomatoes in there as well. That'll boil away. And once the meat has been browned, that's going to go in there just to coat it. It doesn't need to cover the meat because we're gonna put a lid on that and it's gonna go into the oven at about 140 degrees, just so it's that low, slow cook, almost like braising, and you've got the steam coming through as well. So it'll just cook very, very gently. I'm then gonna remove the meat and with the remaining sauce or stock, just take out the whole spices. So take out the cassia bark. What will happen with the cassia bark is it will make it much darker in color. So I'll remove that and I'm gonna blitz it to a nice sort of smooth sauce. So that will make a really lovely thick sauce. I'm then gonna just take off the string and just slice through the breast so you've got lovely little rings of meat. The mashed potato is just normal mashed potato, but in a pan I'm just going to fry off a little bit of onion, some ginger in there, a little bit of turmeric, and then the mashed potato is just going to be warmed up through there so it's a beautiful yellow colour. That mash will then be served on the side. I'm also going to put on some little crispy ribs of the breast, which I've sort of cooked down in a concoction of lots of spices. So it's just been simmering away. And they're just little strips of the breast that I've cut off. And because again, it's quite fatty, it just renders the fat out. Those strips are then pan fried to make them really, really crispy. And we'll be adding a few of those on the plate as well. I think it's really important for people to understand that certain cuts of meat do come in and out of favour, and that's what has an impact on price. Indian food in general has always been a cheap way of cooking because it is, a lot of it is one pot dishes, so you can use cheaper cuts, you know, your neck fillet and things like that just work beautifully in a curry. Provenance has become more and more important, totally. It's important to know where your meat comes from, to know that it's been treated in a certain way. I am very much of the mindset, you know, eat less meat, but eat better quality meat. You need your animals to be treated properly, because if they're not, the meat's not going to be as good. It's very, very simple.